In the dynamic realm of investment opportunities throughout the stock market, exchange-traded funds or ETFs have emerged as a popular choice for investors seeking a diversified exposure to various asset classes. Now, with their flexibility, liquidity, and potential for solid returns, ETFs have captured the attention of seasoned investors and newer investors alike, acting as an instrumental tool in the pursuit of long-term wealth accumulation. But within the vast landscape of ETFs, it becomes crucial to identify those that possess the inherent qualities to fuel your specific journey towards financial prosperity. In this video, we are going to do a deep dive and go through three exceptional ETFs that have not only incredible returns throughout history, but some could also be a great buying opportunity as of right now. Stay tuned because we are going to go through all this and more. But after you, please drop a like in the video and subscribe for more content like this in the future. The first ETF that we are going to go through happens to be one of my all-time favorites. It's SEHD, or the Schwab US Dividend Equity ETF. Now, SEHD is an exchange-traded fund launched and managed by Charles Schwab Investment Group. This fund invests in public equity markets across the US. It invests in stocks of companies operating across energy, materials, industrials, consumer discretionary, consumer staples, healthcare, financials, information technology, communication services, and utility sectors. The fund invests in growth and value stocks of companies across diversified market capitalization. It invests in dividend-paying stocks of companies, and it seeks to track the performance of the Dow Jones US Dividend 100 Index. Now, SEHD happens to be one of my favorite ETFs because with my personal investment goals and strategy, I favor a little bit higher yield and thoroughly enjoy cash flow on a consistent basis. So on those fronts, SEHD definitely provides. Now, since inception, SEHD is currently up 176%. This ETF was started in 2011 and has a very, very low expense ratio of just 0.06%, which definitely allows long-term investors like myself that might be holding hundreds, if not thousands, of shares of SEHD to definitely save some money on the expense ratio. SEHD's 52-week range is 65.96 is the low and 79.49 is the high. So SEHD is still trading a tiny bit towards the 52-week range low, although it has recovered nicely over the past week or so. Now, for the investors out there that favor ETFs that are highly diversified, SEHD definitely fits the bill. The holding breakdowns are industrials at 17%, healthcare at 16%, financials at 14%, consumer defensive at 13%, technology at 13%, consumer cyclical at 9%, energy at 8%, communication at 4%, basic materials at almost 2%, and utilities just under 1%. Now, SEHD has some very well-known top 10 holdings: Broadcom, Pepsi, Merck, Cisco, Coca-Cola, The Home Depot, Texas Instruments, Pfizer, Chevron, Amgen. Now, when it comes to all the holdings within SEHD, a few things are very important. These companies all have a relatively strong financial footing, as well as paid dividends and also have increased their dividends over the long term. Which, speaking of dividends, like I said, this is one of my favorite parts about SEHD. As of right now, you can currently buy in at a 3.68% trailing 12-month dividend yield and a $2.64 trailing 12-month annual payout. But wait, guys, it gets even better than that. SEHD has a history of consistently raising their dividends over the past 10 or so years. So simply put, what this means is that whatever SEHD is currently paying out on a quarterly basis or even an annual basis as of right now, they will likely, at least historically, be paying out more and more to the shareholders over the long term. Now, the next ETF that definitely has and can make long-term investors filthy rich is VIG, or the Vanguard Dividend Appreciation Index Fund. Now, this fund is managed by Vanguard and invests in public equity markets of the United States. The fund invests in stocks of companies operating across diversified sectors, and the fund invests in growth and value stocks of companies across different market capitalizations. Now, this fund seeks to track the performance of the S&P 500 Dividend Growers Index. And what's extremely impressive of VIG is the capital appreciation that the fund has seen over the past 10 or so years. On the max chart, this fund is up 215% plus on the share price of the ETF. VIG also has a very diversified portfolio with a lot of super high quality names inside of it. The holding breakdown is 20% technology, financials are 17%, healthcare 16%, industrials is 12, consumer defensive is 12, consumer cyclical is 7, basic materials 4, energy is 3, utilities is 3, and communication is 1. And VIG's top 10 holdings are Microsoft, Apple, Exxon, United Health Group, Johnson & Johnson, JP Morgan, Procter & Gamble, Visa, MasterCard, and The Home Depot. All extremely high quality companies if you ask me. Now, what's cool about VIG is there are over 300 holdings in the overall portfolio. which makes it even more diversified than something like SCHD. Now, VIG does have a smaller starting dividend yield compared to SCHD, 1.93% as far as the trailing 12-month dividend yield, and the annual payout is $3.03. Now, just like SCHD, this fund also has a long-term history of paying dividends on time on a quarterly basis. And also, as you see very clearly, they've been raising their dividend consistently over the past 10 plus years. Which once again simply means, whatever you're getting paid today, you will likely get paid more in the future, and possibly significantly more. The last ETF that definitely has and will continue to make a lot of long-term investors filthy rich is VYM. Now, VYM, or the Vanguard High Dividend Yield ETF, is an exchange-traded fund that's managed by Vanguard Group. This fund also invests in companies in the United States and also companies across a diversified sector. Now, VYM has an expense ratio of just 0.06%, which is exactly the same as the other two. VYM is up 108.72% as of all-time chart, just over the last 10 or so years. Now, VYM is also heavily diversified, with financials being 19% as the most, consumer defensive at 15, healthcare at 14, industrials at 11, energy at 10, technology at 8, utilities at 7, consumer cyclical at 6, communication at 3, basic materials at 2, and a tiny bit of real estate. Now, VYM's top 10 holdings are a little bit different than the last few, but throughout the funds, there's definitely some overlap and some familiar names. We have ExxonMobil at the top, Johnson & Johnson, JP Morgan, Procter & Gamble. Then we have Chevron, Home Depot, Merck, AbbVie, Pepsi, and Coca-Cola. Now, VYM also does offer a dividend somewhere right in the middle of the last two as far as dividend yield goes. VYM's trailing 12-month dividend yield is around 3.15%. And the annual payout trailing 12 months is $3.31. And just like VIG and SCHD, VYM has consistently been raising their dividend every single few quarters or so over the past 10 plus years. So now that we went over all three of these awesome ETFs that I definitely recommend you look into for sure, let's go through and stack them up next to each other and see what they've returned as far as total return goes. So year to date, VIG is number one, up 4.28%. Then next, VYM is down 1.87%, and SCHD is down 4.03%. Over the last 365 days, VIG is number one at 4.16% in the green. VYM is down 1.81%, and SCHD is down 4.18%. The last 3 years, though, is much different. SCHD is number one now in the last 3 years, up 40.49% return. VIG is next at 35%, and VYM is just over 33% return over the past 3 years. Now, over the past 5 years, SCHD makes number one at 66.56% total return. VIG is number two at 65.22%, and VYM's total return is 43.63% over the past 5 years. So SCHD does come out on top if you were to stack all three of these funds up next to each other and use total return as a metric. But the reality is, in my opinion, all these funds offer a long-term wealth generation vehicle that will continue to compound for years and years and years. But I want to hear what you guys think down below. If you were only able to invest into one of these ETFs long-term, which would it be and why? If you enjoyed this video, make sure to please drop a like on the video and subscribe for more content like this in the future. Thanks as always for stopping by, and I'll see you in the next one.